Tamahanga Tukunga arrived in Auckland last year to visit his family for a month when he received news that would change his life.
I also plan to just go do some blood works whilst I'm here. A day after the blood work, they called me to be taken to the emergency room ASAP because my blood level is very, very dangerous. So they diagnosed me with kidney failure.
The 24-year-old needed urgent dialysis at Middlemore Hospital.
As anyone would at my age, you start thinking, am I going to die? What's going to happen?
Tamahanga is not a New Zealand resident, so he's extended his visa to undergo private treatment to stay alive.
It's had a drastic impact in my life. I've had to put on hold career goals, you know. I had mapped out what I want to do by the time I turn, you know, for example, 30. I would have done this and this. But everything has to come to a halt.
That's not the only reason he's here. Dialysis treatment is not available in Tonga, largely due to the costs involved.
We estimate the pool of patients with stage 5 chronic kidney disease requiring some form of kidney support, either transplant or dialysis, would be about 50 to 60. So to spend a big amount of money, unfortunately, we have to talk costs. On a small group of people, it's just not feasible at the moment.
But it's a ticking time bomb in the kingdom as the number of people who need dialysis treatment is likely to grow.
Around 10,000 people have type 2 diabetes here on Tonga's main island, Tongatapu. Eventually they'll need dialysis, but with no treatment available here in the kingdom, they will die.
Single mother of two, Yunala Tu, is one of the patients desperately needing dialysis, but she can't afford treatment overseas.
If I go and have a dialysis, only me by myself, my kids gonna be live here. And that's why if in here it's good. And I said, what about if they take me there and I stay there forever? I don't know what time I'm going to see my kids.
Dr. Latu is focused on early prevention to combat the kidney disease, and he's hopeful there will be a private clinic in Tonga to take the pressure off the local health system.
I certainly support that. If we can't do it, but other private organisations can do, all the more so. That's commendable for my part. Because certainly, within our means at the moment, we can't do it.
Back here in New Zealand, Counties Monaco alone has around 630 patients on dialysis, and costs are high when the patient is not eligible for free treatment.
The healthcare they would need has to be paid for, and primarily the responsibility rested on the family and the community at large. And in terms of dialysis and renal replacement therapy, it's not cheap. It is expensive.
Tamahanga is at the dialysis clinic 3 days a week and takes up to 6 hours a session, costing his family around $1,000 a week.
I'm only here, to be honest, by the grace of God and his help and guidance and persuading whoever it is that had to come and donate to the cost of my treatment.
Family and friends have pitched in online to help pay for his hospital costs, and his parents in Tonga send yam, taro and tapioca to sell in New Zealand to fund his much-needed treatment.
We're just waiting on my residency, but I have my siblings and my parents both offering to donate me a kidney if they are a match.
He's put his law degree on hold and his health first while he adjusts to new life until he has a new kidney.
This is where I may be able to live, so I don't even have a choice in the matter. So it's either adjust or be depressed and be down every single day, and I choose not to. I choose, you know, to carry on.
Wow, such a heartbreaking story, an incredible young man. I hope there's a solution for him and other Tongans too.
And thank you, Tamahanga, for sharing your story with us.